Columbia engineering is very different. I mean, we talk about engineering for humanity, right? It's a new way of thinking. Now consequences are everything. What are the societal challenges? Everywhere you look are things you have to solve. There are things you can do better, or there are things that require breakthrough solutions. So think about it. Think about what it is that's there. Think about what is not there. What is it that you would want it to be? And there is your next problem.
So I'm using nanotechnology to solve problems in the energy, water, food nexus.
So everybody understands the problem with plastics. The immediate solution is accepting that you're going to have plastics for the near future, but make them more recyclable. Number two is walk away from hydrocarbon-based materials. And go to things that are cellulosic-based, things that are more obviously recyclable. Think about electrical power. Right now, it's all done by burning carbon, right? Are there other sustainable ways of doing it? Can we use solar power? Or can we use wind power? These are all things chemical engineers do. So if you think about solar power, it's right now the state of the art is amorphous silicon. So it's very expensive to make that, so that if you put a solar panel on your roof, even if you sell back the power you make, it takes 20 years to break even. If I make that from 20 years to 2 years, suddenly everybody will be doing it. So the further back you are, all you care about is making something that's better in terms of performance, but then it has to sort of integrate into a system, which is the human society. And then the questions become much more ethical, become policy, become money, in addition to performance. So we start at the molecule level. We go all the way right now up to processing and making the molecules. Where the next direction, the next steps are, is what I call the macro scale. So once you've made something, how do you get people to start using it? How do you get the policy makers to accept it? And then you think about how do you start thinking about cost? How do you start thinking about the carbon footprint it leaves? What is the environmental impact? These are the questions that we are starting to get into. Once we get to that, then we go all the way from molecular design all the way to societal impact.